Yeah.
Oh my word, look at all that.
Was that okay? Okay, cool.
Well, although I don't approve of the drought conditions we're in, I do approve of this. Because as it turns out, the warm weather that we've been having, and the cool nights have actually accelerated the fall colors change.
It's pretty.
Yep, there's always a happy medium to everything.
It still runs really cheap.
Wow. Wow, wow, wow.
Yep.
This is like out in my life. Originally there was a bridge over us and then back again. And on the way back, you kept seeing all these cars passing.
This is pretty tough for my mind.
Yep, that's the whistle.
We pass under Route 61 yet again as we approach Port Clinton, the operational headquarters of the Reading and Northern Railroad. As I mentioned earlier, we will be stopping at Port Clinton Station to board more passengers at the platform in front of our corporate offices. As we will pause only long enough to board those passengers, we ask that no one get off the train during this stop, with the exception of designated train crew members. Port Clinton, home to the Port Clinton Hotel, served as a stagecoach stop between Sunbury and Philadelphia in the early 1800s. The Port Clinton Hotel was a great social center where news from other states and even foreign countries was exchanged. In fact, it became customary when signing the hotel register to add any news that one thought might be of common interest. The Schuylkill Canal was an important transportation link. The last boat to leave Port Clinton's once crowded basin was the Mary Rose, which took a load of coal to the state sanatorium at Hamburg just before the outbreak of World War II in 1939. The railroad became the dominant form of transportation in Port Clinton from the mid-1800s on. Port Clinton is located 78 miles north of Philadelphia on the former Reading Company main line. Today, Port Clinton is an important crossroads on Route 61, just north of Interstate 78.
Then there's a
turn.